Hi friends, welcome back to CSS Zero to Hero. This series is for beginners who wants to learn CSS. In this video, I'm going to talk about another important property, display. Let's start. The display property is the most important CSS property for controlling layout. Display property can have many values like none, block, inline, inline block, flex, grid, etc. In which flex and grid are some advanced concepts we need to cover in separate videos. And so I'm going to explain about none, block, inline and inline block in this video. I have asked the difference between block and inline block to many candidates who attended UI interviews so far. The saddest part is more than 90% of them don't know the difference between block and inline block. Some candidates know the difference between block and inline. But after they say the difference, if I ask the difference between block and inline block, or inline and inline block, they struggle. Let me try to explain the differences and so you will never forget. But to understand the differences between these properties, we need to first understand the difference between block level elements and inline elements. This is actually not a CSS concept, this is a concept in HTML. To explain this, let me create a div and a span. Let me also have some text inside both of the elements. And so we can see this. Let me duplicate both. Now we can see block level elements are shown in separate lines, but both inline elements are shown in the same line. This is because a block level element always starts on a new line and it always takes up the full width. An inline element does not start on a new line and it only takes up as much width required. If I add some background colors, we can understand. This is the first difference. Okay, now let me add some width, some height, and a margin top to both the classes. Let me refresh. Now we can see the width, height, and margin top are applied to the block level elements, but to the inline elements, these are not applied. So the second difference is width, height, margin top, and margin bottom can be applied to only block level elements. Those does not have any effect on inline elements. Okay. Now let's move to the CSS concept. First, let me create three CSS classes. Like this. If you apply display block to a div, it does not have any effect because div elements are already block level elements. But if we apply display block to span, we can see a difference. Now we can see the inline elements are behaving like block level elements. So from this, we can understand, we can use display block to convert the inline elements to behave like block level elements. Similarly, display inline does not have any effect on inline elements like span. But if we apply display inline to any block level elements, it will behave like an inline element. Okay, but here, after we apply display inline, we can see it is behaving like inline element. And so the width, height, and margin top are not having any effect. In case if you want to show all the contents in the same line like inline elements, but in the same time you also want to apply some block level element properties like width, height, margin top, and margin bottom, in that case we can use display inline block. Now if I refresh, we can see all contents are in same line like inline elements, and all of them have width, height, margin top applied like block level elements. So we can understand an inline block element is placed as an inline element, but it behaves as a block level element. Hope you are clear on block, inline and inline block. Now let's see the last one, display none. When we apply display none, that element will not be shown. If I explain this using this example, it may confuse you. So let me comment this and create three divs. For the first one and last one, let me use the red class, and for the second one, let me use the blue class. And so we can see it clearly. Now let me create a new class and have display none. I'm going to apply this class to the blue div. If I refresh, we can see the blue div is not displaying. But when we talk about display none, we have to talk about another property called visibility, for which we can use the value as hidden to hide the element. But the difference between display none and visibility hidden is display none releases the space, and so the next element occupies the space. Here we can see the next red div is moved to the position of blue. In the meantime, visibility hidden will not release the space. Let me change display none to visibility hidden. Now if I refresh, we can see the blue div is hidden, but the red div is not moved because blue div is still holding its space. And the opposite of visibility hidden is visibility visible. And so we can see our blue div is back. Hope you understood. See you in my next video. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel and support me. Thank you. Bye.